So inflammation can be pro-tumor or anti-tumor. And by the way, talking about curbing inflammation, aspirin is, it sounds like it's a good thing, but it's actually also limited. Again, another double-edged sword, because aspirin at low dose can suppress all this inflammation that is going on, but it also has a danger of triggering bleeding because it's a blood thinner, essentially. And so, again, one way out of this conundrum, again, in work with Deepak Panigrahi in Boston and others, is to find ways to benefit from this anti-inflammatory effect of aspirin without also having to accept that it can cause bleeding. And if we dissect the molecular pathways, then I think there are ways to do that. And that's actually active research going on here. Aspirin is a good example. Now, what we all also know is the many new ways that we have discovered for how aspirin works. It's not just blocking prostaglandins, which is a traditional thinking, but it also stimulates the synthesis of resolvins, which again is a work of Deepak in Boston together with Charlie Serhan, also in Boston. And that's a new molecule that can, there's a nice property that it promotes the removal of debris, it's anti-inflammatory, and it does not block the other good side of inflammation, which is the activation of the immune system. Now, for the body to make these resolvins, it can be promoted by aspirin, but aspirin needs a substrate, and one of the substrates for making resolvins is omega-3. Fatty acids, and that's probably one reason why omega-3 fatty acids are healthy for you, but I think it works best in conjunction with aspirin.